Hello, everyone. This is Joe Chen from Qualcomm. I'm truly honored to be a speaker in the 2021 Computex Cyber World Forum. Today, I'm going to give you a presentation on cybersecurity in connected vehicle. Today's agenda, basically, we will cover connected vehicle and the cyber attack on the ITS, or Intelligent Transportation System, and vehicle. And what is the standard on the automobile cybersecurity? And what is the solution for the automobile cybersecurity? Finally, I'm going to share with you one of the projects in the 5G connected vehicle project that we have done in Taiwan. What's the lesson we have learned? The history of the automobile evolution or revolution starting from 18th century. At that time, the steam engine vehicle come into the market. Into the 19th century, the combustion vehicle become the most popular vehicle. And then come into the 20th century, the gasoline and the diesel vehicle become the most popular vehicle. Plus, I think the automatic transmission also become very important invention at that time. And then into the 21st century, because of the environmental concern, people start to come up with a hybrid vehicle with the engine and the electric power supply together. And then moving to the 21st century, later part of 21st century, electric vehicle, which is Tesla is the most famous for, become the dominant electrical vehicle into the market. Into the future, we see autonomous vehicle will be the most important market force in the future. I think we should most focus on is the electrical vehicle. Electrical vehicle, a lot of module become software-driven, and that become a cybersecurity issue. For connected vehicle, starting from the left-hand side, a lot of people, when they're driving, they want to be able to continue to listen to the music they like to listen, for example, the Spotify. Or the kids in the car, they like to continue to watch the video from the store, video store, they like the video. So infotainment become an important connected information source. Secondly, I think the telematic become a very important connected vehicle information source also. For example, the GPS navigation become a very important telematic service for the connected vehicle. On the right-hand side, finally, on the right-hand side, V2X, this has become the most dominant important connected vehicle subject. For example, vehicle to vehicle, or vehicle to roadside unit, or vehicle to base station. Basically, these three cloud, or we should say, or these three most important connected service are the area that we talk about the connected vehicle. Because of the connected vehicle, now you can real-time provide the information to the cloud, so to speak, infotainment or telematic or V2X cloud. There's a lot of service you can provide now. For example, the real-time diagnostic on the car, that if the car performance start to degrade or degradation on the car, the cloud provider can real-time inform the driver that the car has some performance issue, that you should go to the garage to fix that problem. Also, there's a lot of navigation can help the driver to navigate the road that he like to go. And also the weather condition and the environmental condition can provide information to the driver. I think the most important thing is the driver's health condition can also be monitored. Okay, so in case the driver has a heart attack, that information can be provided to the cloud, and the cloud can inform the proper organization to really address this concern. An insurance company can also look at the driver behavior to determine, for example, the insurance premium. Over the air, a lot of software real-time need to be updated in the car. So over the air services to update the software is also very important. This is all the connected car service and data that can provide it, because of the car now can real-time connected to the cloud. Because of the car now connected to the cloud or connected to the other vehicle, there are several potential cyber attacks can against the individual car and the overall system. The overall system we talk about is the intelligent transportation system. From the left-hand side of the cyber attack, if the attacker get close to your car and they can physically connect it to a certain port to the car, then you just connect it to the car and you can download any malware into the car to damage the car or steal the car. And then the attacker can attack the cloud instead of the individual car. They attack the cloud because the cloud has a lot of server and a lot of back-end platform. And also there's a lot of management system. If the attacker attack the cloud, hacker attack the cloud, and then from there they can manage multiple or a lot of car or the car vehicle fleet management. That would be a problem. Finally, because of the connected car often connected to the cloud or the other cars through wireless interface, so hacker can attack the overall ITS systems through the wireless attack. For example, the 5G cellular system or the Wi-Fi system, and also the car and car V2X connection. So basically, these are the three areas that the hacker can attack the overall connected vehicle system. For individual car, for example, the hacker can attack the individual car from four important entry points, starting from the left-hand upper side, the sensor. For example, the sensor would sense the information that to open the car, to open the ignition. So if the hacker can attack the sensor, they can get into the car. And then, you know, like I say, the electrical car now, in the car, there's a CAN bus. They can jam in the CAN bus. They can do a lot of damage to the CAN bus. On the left-hand side, on the bottom part, there's a telematic, for example, the navigation service to the cloud. They can hack into the cloud through the telematic cloud and then get into the car, get into to manage where you want to go. And then from the right-hand side on the bottom is infotainment. A lot of times the hacker can hack into the app, the infotainment app, for example, the Spotify or the Netflix. They can hack into the infotainment app and then from there get into the car. Finally, if you go up to the right-hand side upper part, you have a physical connection. The hacker can connect a box into the physical port. They can download the malware and then create a lot of damage into the car. So basically, cyber attack, you have two areas. One is an individual car and one is an intelligent transportation system. And this is the area that the hacker can attack. Based on some of the survey in the 2021 from the upstream, most of the attack right now is in the cloud, in the server. And some then is in the keyless entry and a keyless fab. But anyway, you can see all the attack really come across different category. And so it's just a matter of time the hacker can attack a different category. And the consequence of this attack is either you have a vehicle accident or you get this car was stolen and the financial loss is worse than that. Sometimes it can create a lot of traffic jam. This is just some of the breakdown of the impact. Most critical now is the data breach and some of the car was stolen. So since the cyber security is so important, the industry has come together to publish some of the important cybersecurity standard. Here we just kind of emphasize two. On the left-hand side, you can see ISO 21434. This is a standard basically assess and prioritize and identify the security issue inside the car. Okay. On the right-hand side, there's the ISO 26262 standard. This is really from the functionality, identify if the car component has any problem, malfunction problem, what would be the malfunction causing the safety concern. So that is a two standard, look at it from a different angle about the cybersecurity concern. The other thing is very important is we look at the life cycle. you know, from the concept to the design, every validation, implementation, production, every life cycle, there's a different standard associated different life cycle. This is very critical. Inside the car, every car component, there's also a standard to identify which car component should have certain technical content and certain technical security requirement. So how do we assess the car or the system is secure? You can use a lot of technique and also tool. Here are the three different tools. For example, on the right-hand side, there's a risk assessment tool. You can use a TARA, a risk assessment tool, to assess the current car security concern. And then this is the overall ITS concern. Okay, for example, from the top, you have the cloud. In the cloud, you have a different server. Over the air download server, you have telematic server, app server, and then you have endpoint protection you should put in there. And then in the cloud, you should have an NG firewall to protect the cloud. And then all this information, you can go into the right-hand side is a platform. For example, the platform will do the AI or machine learning, analyze any threat concern. From the top, there's an automobile threat intelligence can provide the intelligent information to the platform to analyze zero-day concern. And all this information was provided to the vehicle security operations center to do proper response. So this is an overall system cybersecurity solution that we can address, we can respond to the cybersecurity concern. For individual car, we break the individual car into different modules. For example, the vehicle server, the domain controller, the instrument cluster, but most important, you have a secure gateway. All the internal CAN bus have to go through the security gateway to ensure that is secure. I think we into the final part. We're going to share with you one of the projects Qualcomm has done in Taiwan. This project was awarded by the Ministry of Transportation and Communication. Basically, the MOTC is trying to leverage the 5G communication with a connected vehicle, and then eventually to do autonomous car driving. In this project, they also try to enhance the current traffic control management system. So phase one, we have created a different scenario. For example, how does the car provide real-time traffic information to the traffic controller so that the traffic control center can real-time proper manage the traffic flow to make the traffic much easier to go through? And then how do you spot, in the blind side, how do you spot a car to create more safety concern for vehicle driving? In the phase two, we were going to look at the whole theater. How do we ensure you have a secure theater in a connected car environment? So this is a phase two environment. I think in summary, what I'd like to say is that this is just a beginning of the journey for the connected car. And cybersecurity is a foundation of the connected vehicle's future and will play a very important role in the connected vehicles development. I want to thank you for your attention and your time. Thank you very much.